Hi, y'all. I'm Queen Latifah. And today, I'm here to encourage you to visit small.
How about you drop into Martha K LLC in Minneapolis, Minnesota?
Just one of many small businesses that are benefiting with the help from Lenovo Evolve Small. And me, the queen of small. What are you waiting for?
I'm in my gold chain, reppin', my God. Rockin' Bucks and J's, reppin', my God. Said I couldn't be fly, reppin', my God. Boxes that they try to put us in.
Say what?
There's more to it.
Wow.
Going places.
Wow.
But I'm far from the basic.
Say what?
Tradition. It's more about relation and where my heart stands. What God chose to be true.
Hey everyone, hey, just checking in real quick. I may make this a Facebook reel or a Facebook My Story post, I don't know yet, but it's just a little ranting and raving about current events and next steps for everything. I'm sorry that I did not get to post a YouTube video last week. I've been dealing with the death in my family. As I had posted on my YouTube, I've been dealing with the death in my family. So, that kind of took, you know, first priority over my blogging and vlogging life. So let's get to it. Oh, as always, please, watch my PerPay review video about PerPay, and as well as sign up for PerPay. I get $100, you get $100, and it's really great because the great thing about it is that it goes according to your income. PerPay does is buy now, pay later. But the great thing about PerPay that sets them different than like Afterpay or Klarna or any of the other ones is that PerPay, you pay with your paycheck before you get it. I know some people may not like it that way, but I do, because like, all right, you know what I'm saying? Like, once I get my money, everything that I own is already paid for. I don't have to worry about it. And one great thing too is that my credit card gets paid off. I get paid weekly. I know some people get paid bi-weekly or monthly or whatever. Or semi-monthly. I get paid weekly, so every week my credit card is paid off, so I don't have to worry about paying my credit card off, which is really great. So, you know, and I've been kicking it up a little bit more. Right now I'm at like $195 per week, which like $100 and some odd goes towards my credit card, and then the other amount goes towards my payment for PerPay Marketplace. Like I said, the link to sign up for PerPay is in the description of this video. It will always be in the description of all my videos. And like I said, once again, this is #TransProud. This is #TransProud channel. And what I want to say, shoot. Oh, I wanted to get this out in one little word, but it's okay. This is #TransProud. I just wanted to let everybody know that this is a lifestyle channel. This is a channel to document and to also videotape and also continuously document things that have to do with the trans woman or trans community or just trans things. I'm also going to talk about tech. I'm also going to talk about life things such as like PerPay and things of that nature. Let's see what else. I do reviews of things. Like soon I'm about to review my Xbox because I've had it for a while now. So I'm like, maybe I should review it. Also going to review like the smart things in my smart home. I'm not fully done setting them up yet. But once I'm done setting them up, I'll be sure to review them and tell you what all I have and why I chose Google Assistant over Amazon Alexa or, you know, Siri and all the rest of them. And the reason why, I just let you know now, the reason why I chose Google Assistant over the rest is because I'm a Googler. And Google Assistant is going to be smarter than the rest. Amazon Alexa is built off of Android, and all Apple stuff is built off of God darn it!
But I found these results on search.
All Apple stuff is built off of Linux. Yep, all Apple things are built off of Linux, and then they create their own little things from that point on. I'm not an Apple user. Will I learn how to code over there? Yes, I will, but I'm not an Apple user. I'm more of a Googler. My dream job is to work for Google, and like keep that job for a very long time. And like give Google all my ideas, build my company inside of Google and everything. And just to let you know a little bit about my company, Mother K LLC, not Martha K, it's Mother K LLC, is a tech startup and a tech-based consulting firm. And we specialize in computer programming right now and like trans intervention trainings, where we come into communities and nonprofits and schools and things of that nature and train people on to how to treat trans people, whether they're young, old, crippled, or crazy. And that's that. Okay, now to get on to my topic of the day. I know I ain't got my wig on this time. I know it's a little weird. Mother ain't never recorded a video without her wig, but that's okay. Like I said, that's been just an impromptu week. Let me see. Okay. So when people ask the question, do you stand with Israel? Do you stand with Palestine? I don't stand with either party. And the reason why I don't stand with either party is because, first off, I don't believe in war. Second off, God told the Israelis or the Israelites or Israelis to go and take over Israel because that's supposed to be their land. But in the Bible, it says that we don't own any land. And I don't know. Like, I personally don't agree with, I don't agree with the way that things are going. I personally felt like people could have continued to talk it out. They could have came to a better solution. They could have came to a better resolution. Instead of attacking each other or attacking Israel and tearing Israel up, because Israel is a beautiful place. It's a very beautiful country. I've been when I was like way, 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 way younger. Yeah, so that's my stance on that. I just wish God didn't tell them to go there. I wish God would have led them somewhere else or put it on their hearts to go somewhere else instead of continuously holding down Israel and things are like getting worse and things of that nature. So that's one current event. Let me talk about the new Pixel 8 Pro and 8. I have a Pixel 6a. I don't think I'm going to get the Pixel 8 Pro or 8. I think I'm gonna wait until my software updates are done on this phone. That's the great thing about having a Google Pixel. I think I'm supported for like 3 or 4 years, not the new 7, but I am supported for like, I want to say 3 or 4 years. I really like my Pixel 6a. It was like one of my first Google Pixel devices. I really like all the smart features. Like there's a such thing as call wait, where Google Assistant will hold on the phone for you. Until a customer representative comes to the phone. It's also like a AI directory or AI assistance directory where it directs you in the call. And it pops up like a whole transcript and tells you what's going to happen next or what button to press. Just in case you forget what button to press. My only problems with it is I wish that it worked on all numbers. I wish that, like, you know what I'm saying, it worked for all numbers, all business numbers, not just certain numbers. I think it only works for 1-800 numbers and things of the nature. And really, one cool thing, too, Google Assistant can also book you a hair appointment, a table, the movies, a flight. Google Assistant can also buy you things, all types of crazy things. That's another reason why I chose Google Assistant, because she's so deeply integrated into my life that I was like, yeah, I'm just gonna choose this assistant. I don't personally feel that Alexa or Siri or the other ones would have served my purpose. I personally feel like they would have defeat the purpose. Okay, and then, so that's one current event. And then the next current event is, last current event I'm going to talk about is Trump. I don't know if I have any Trump supporters that follow my channel. I hope you don't, because I don't believe in following Trump. I believe he is, I believe he's the devil. And I believe he was here as, I believe he was brought to hindsight. To be the anarchy. Simpsons showed us years ago that this was going to happen. Simpsons also showed us that, you know, he was supposed to die within his presidency. He didn't. So, but that's one prediction that Simpsons got wrong. I don't know how many other predictions they got wrong, but that's one prediction I know for a fact that they got wrong. But yeah, I just don't get it. If my black self had committed the same crimes that Trump has committed and a verdict has been rose against them. You know what I'm saying? Like, this person has been indicted and everything. If my black self had committed all those crimes, you know my black self in this country would have been thrown under the jail. Not into the jail, but under to jail. And correct me if I'm wrong, honey. Any other black person would have had the same issues. Like, I don't get it why he is above the law because he's white. I don't feel that Trump should be above the law. I feel that the law should also take his nasty ass down, excuse my language, because he's a horrible person. He doesn't support black people. He don't support women. He don't support this. He don't support that. He also likes to feel on women's pussies and all types of things. I don't agree with any of it. So all you Trump supporters out there, honey, good luck. I don't feel like he needs to run for president again. I don't feel like we should. I don't feel like he should have been elected the first time. I feel that he got elected because this country became lazy. Black people didn't go out and vote. The 1 year for lowest record numbers of black voters. So I don't, that's why I feel like he got elected. But hopefully he doesn't get elected again. Hopefully, like, nothing crazy goes on that, like, he's able to run for president again. I don't get it. Like, I don't see it for him. And I don't feel that the Republican Party should see it for him neither. I feel that they need better representation. I'm sorry, I'm not a Republican. And I'm not a Democrat neither. But if I had to lean towards one or the other, I guess I would be more of a Democrat. But I personally don't feel that the Republican Party is being represented correctly. Like, I don't feel that Trump represents their party correctly. Like, I feel that someone else needs to represent their party. How about go find a black Republican or something, please? Like, why not more black faces inside of constituencies? You know, because mother someday is going to be a constituent. I don't want to be president. I don't want to be governor. I just want to be mayor. I may want to be governor, but I just want to be like, I want to start off as like mayor and then work my way up to governor and things of that nature. But that's going to be later on in life. Once I get my coins together and can afford to be a constituent, and actually have a platform to run on, because right now I don't have very many things that I can run on, but. But that's it for current events. Maybe I'll do more current event videos if this one gets a lot of views and people like it and things of that nature. All right. Peace out. As always, please like and subscribe my channel. Thank you. Like I said, this is hashtag trans proud with a Z. Trans proud with a Z. Hashtag trans proud with a Z. All right. Thank you. Bye-bye.